I came to BioAccelerator because I had a herniated disc. I woke up in Las Vegas, and they say what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, but that's not always true. So I woke up and my neck started hurting. And over the next couple months, this was only, like 5 months ago, my neck started hurting more and more, and pain just got worse. And I knew something had gone really wrong as I started feeling like numbness in my fingers. So I got an MRI and they were like, you have a extremely bad herniated C6, C7. And when I called BioAccelerator, I'd done a ton of research on different clinics, and this seemed like the best option. So one of the main reasons I chose not to look in the US is because the FDA has just made it very difficult for the forefront of medical technology to be pushed inside of the United States. Mesenchymal stem cells specifically are mainly done outside of the US, and it seemed like this was the best option all around. I did an IV treatment, I did the hair and the face, and then I also did the intradiscal, so they did my C2, C3, C4, C5, and then I had an artificial disc replacement in December, so they didn't have to do the C6, C7, but they did the C7 T1, which is underneath because of some nerve damage in my chest and then nerve damage down my shoulder and down my tricep. So they did a lot. They did a lot in 1 week. And so.
The electromyography with neuroconduction, okay?
Yes.
Okay, it's important for me that is exam because this is the neuroconduction on the C7 left, okay? This is the normal neuroconduction. When you have when you do a normal neuroconduction, you have the first one, and this is the first shock with the electromyography, and this is the second answer of the nerve, okay? But in this graphic, this is the first shock, and the second one is a little bit. But yes, it's important for me because you have a fibrillation in the nerves, but I see conduction in the nerve. Yes. It's a difference with the first one electromyography. In the first one with the electromyography, there was a total or complete lesion on the C7 nerve. But in this electromyography, I see partial with gray lesion, but partial lesion. For that reason, for me, it's important to put a stem cell around the nerve in the foramen, okay? I hope with that therapy is possible your recovery, not now, maybe in 1.5 years or 2 years after procedure, there are recovery of the nerve. Why? Because the growing of the nerve until the spinal cord, until maybe the trapezium muscle is 1 millimeter per day, okay? It's so long, a little bit long.
280 days.
Yes. It's one. But for that reason, the stem cell needs first recovery the cover around the nerve, and second one growing the nerve. Yes, for that reason, for me is a good notice that answer of the nerve conduction, and we're going to put a stem cell in the disc and in the foramen. Okay, okay.
The neck I was actually concerned about, and I woke up, I'm a little stiff maybe, but it feels like I did a hard workout. It's not bad at all. So yeah, after the disc, so I was in no pain after I had the surgery, but leading up to that, I was on OxyContin, oxycodone, I was on different medications for different steroids. I mean, I was on gabapentin 3 times a day. And then when I went into the hospital because my disc had started separating, I was on 3 times the gabapentin. I was on 900 milligrams of gabapentin, which just makes you're hammered all day long. You're just drunk feeling all day long. It's not good.